Can you hear me?
Yes.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm very happy to see so many of you here. Last year there weren't so many people Sunday morning. We had this slot. I thought they just don't want me to be heard by too many people. Okay, so great. Thank you for coming out today. I don't have a PowerPoint today because what I want to talk about doesn't have slides and charts and graphs or pictures, because I'm going to talk about the future. I'm going to talk about the future of blogging. I'm a blogger. My name is Ramya Pandey. I've been blogging for about 12 years this year. So I'm going to talk about the future of bloggers as community managers. Now, blogging is a very personal, a very special format to me. And I think what makes it very different from every other way of sharing your thoughts and your stories is the fact that it's a constant work in progress. With a book, you come to an end when you reach the last page of the book. With a movie, it ends when you see the last scene of the movie. And with a song, it ends with the last note. But with a blog, you put up a blog post and then you receive comments. You respond to those comments and then more comments come in. And then you respond again in the form of comments or future blog posts again, further blog posts coming up. Every blogger who's been writing for a few months at least knows this. How many bloggers here in the audience? Just put up hands. Oh, wonderful. I'm so happy to see so many more people here. Great. So all of us know this to be true, right? Blogging is part of a larger narrative. It promotes a conversation. And as bloggers, our jobs are to make sure the conversation never flags, to keep provoking newer conversations, to make sure the existing conversations are going forward, not getting derailed by other things. So tell me, who do you think owns a conversation? Is it the person who starts the conversation? Is it the person who responds to that person? Is it the person who's listening? Is it the phone service provider, the internet service provider who's allowing the conversation to happen? Who do you think owns a conversation? Anybody?
It's a two-way process.
It's a two-way process, and there are possibly multiple people who are part of the conversation. So I'd say everybody who's part of the conversation owns that conversation, right? And if this conversation is happening on the blog, you as the blogger are the custodian of all these conversations. You don't own everything that gets said, and you're not directly responsible, but still you are the custodian. It is your job to manage those conversations and ensure that what you want to say is taken forward in a much bigger way. So that's what makes blogging really special, because it's an ongoing process. It's a work in progress, just like every single one of us is. A conversation, just like a human being, grows with every instance, and it grows over time. And a conversation gets added to with every new person who comes in. The other day I was having lunch with some friends, and one of them said, "I don't really understand this Twitter thing. Why would you want to tell strangers what you're wearing and what you had for dinner last night and what song you're listening to?" Now, I was trying to think about how to explain this whole phenomenon to her with all the cool jargon and the keywords. And my other friend turned to her and said, "I'm on Twitter because I found my tribe on Twitter." I really like this word tribe, because tribe means a group that is usually comprised of families that are bound to each other by social ties, economic ties, blood ties, or something they have in common. And in today's day and age, our tribe is everybody that has something in common with our lifestyle. So everybody who lives in this city who's had to go through the mega block on a weekend, everybody who opens the same toilet door, who understands why it feels a little, it's a little scary to think about what the opposite sex thinks of us. Like all of us know, right? Everybody who's opening the same toilet door that I am, everybody who lives in the city, everybody who shares the same interest, that same obscure author, that same relatively unknown video game, they're all part of my tribe. And we're all part of multiple tribes every day. Now with a blog, we are pushing out conversations and we are finding our tribes very easily right there, because within the blog, we are talking about things that matter to us. When I started my blog about 12 years ago, it wasn't very easy to quantify exactly what I wanted out of the world. I had a lot of the same concerns that every millennial has, which I know now, but the term millennial was not getting thrown about that much either. So I had a good job and a nice family, lots of friends, but the economy was very unstable, it still is. I had a lot of options in the job market, but none of those jobs made me feel either secure or happy, and I couldn't articulate that to the people around me. And I had a lot of concerns like, what are the things I should be looking for in a life partner, because it's such an important decision. But people around me just didn't seem to get that. And I took all that and I put it on my blog. And all around the world, people responded to me saying, I know what you mean. That's exactly where I'm coming from. And I found my tribe right there. And that tribe has just continued to grow with the blog. Many more people getting added in. And their thoughts have helped shape my thinking. And hopefully, I have helped shape the thinking of everyone else who's had a chance to visit my blog. So I've been the custodian of a tribe I found right there. Now, I'm going to do a little exercise here. So this is going to be my blog. The stage is the blog. The mic. So this is going to be my blog, okay? I have nothing to do this weekend. I know everything is so expensive.
Hey, I run a board games community. You guys should come and play with me.
Sounds really boring. But what you could do is go to WordCamp.
I could give you guys 10% discount at restaurants.
Spam.
Hey, board games sounds interesting. Can I come?
Let us know what time and where. So these are my commenters. These are the readers who came to my blog. And you see what I did here. In this one conversation, I started tailoring which way the discussion is going. I sent out the irrelevant conversation, and the conversation that maybe didn't have as much interest for me, I set it aside, and I followed up with one conversation which I thought could go in one direction. I started putting certain restrictions, certain boundaries, and I started defining my tribe a little more tightly. So a community is a tribe that takes on certain structures and has a certain hierarchy. A community is a group of people that have a common objective and some way to reach that objective. And a blogger is well poised to take that forward, take the tribe they already have into going into something called a community. So 2 years ago, after I had been through so many years of blogging, I was by then a very happy blogger because I was doing something that I really enjoyed doing. I now write for a living. I blog for a living as well. But I blog about writing, I blog about fiction, I blog about life, love, this city. And all around me, I was surrounded by people who said, nice, you write very well. Why do you write? And I really needed somebody who did ask me that question because maybe they were doing the same thing. So I called up 4 of my friends and I said, hey, why don't we meet for coffee? And I told them all, this time bring along something that you've written. And the fact that not a single one of them asked me why made me think, okay, I'm maybe doing this the right way. So all 4 of them came and met me, and they didn't know each other, by the way. So one person was a tractor salesman, one of them was a digital marketer, one of them was a student, I was a writer, and one more person was, again, somebody who was doing something on his own. The 5 of us sat and had a conversation for 3 hours. We talked about writing, we talked about the things we had written, we talked about what kind of authors we really liked. And at the end of those 3 hours, all of us said, we really enjoyed this. We want to do this again. We want to do this again and again. So we had the meeting again another week later. And then one more person came along and joined us. Then we had it one more week later. And slowly, little by little, more people started getting added. Somebody went out and wrote a blog post about us. Somebody else read that blog post and wrote to me saying, can I also come and be part of these meetings you're having? And I said, sure, come on in. And we said, let's call it Alphabet Sambar. Because we really, all of us, I really like sambar, and this is everybody who likes alphabets and words. So let's put them all together, the different ingredients, and make it an alphabet sambar. And with every meet, we started adding a few more rules and refining what we wanted to do. We said everybody has to bring something that they've written, because it's very difficult for people who write to share their true selves with other people. But we are all writers, yes, we all understand what that feels like. So let's share our writing with each other. Let's help each other become better writers. Let's say that, okay, you know what? Maybe that one would work better if you wrote it this way. This one would be nicer if you read this author and wrote it the way they would do it. And with all of these meetings and these conversations, all of us grew as writers. Over time, we started encouraging each other and we started saying, let us be responsible for building each other's confidence and developing each other as better people and better writers. So we said, we're going to institute an apology jar. We have this at every single one of our meets. And the apology jar basically says, if you apologize for your writing, if you say, no, I'm sorry, you know, I don't really write so well, and I'm not really that good a writer, then you have to pay 100 rupees into that apology jar. And at the end of the meet, whatever money is there is used to buy something to eat for everyone. Now, the result of this is we are all constantly competing to see who doesn't apologize. And that means we've all gone into a place where we're saying, I'm a great writer, and you apologize right here. I'm an awesome writer, I'm a better writer than all of you. And can you think about what this does for our levels of confidence? If we can stand and talk to five other people and say, I'm a great writer, we are able to go out and do that when we talk to publishers, when we talk to our audiences, when we talk to everybody else we need as writers to take our writing forward. And that's helped tremendously. Every single member of this community has benefited from this. People wrote into us and said that, people in other cities wrote to us and said, we want something like this as well. So we said, okay, we'll put this on Facebook, we'll have a Facebook group, and we can do this online as well. So what started as online went to offline, and then it came back to online. We have an email group which helps us track our events and send out our meeting events on a basis, on a regular basis. We've got a WhatsApp group which coordinates locations. Our Facebook group today spans multiple locations. We've got members in 16 cities, 6 countries, and every continent in the world except Africa. That will happen this year. I'm sure of it, because we are all awesome writers. We do everything from novels to blog posts to poetry, haiku, Twitter fiction, travelogues, song scripts, song lyrics, movie scripts, play scripts. All of this we've looked at and more. We've had more than 100 meets. We've gone on to do much bigger things. We've done a novel writing boot camp. And the word lounge that some of you have had a chance to attend through yesterday, and it's going to be running through today as well. We've been doing exercises, we've been doing workshops. None of that could have been done by one single person alone. I could not have done a single one of those things, let alone all of those things together. And the entire event of word lounge that has happened has been the collective effort of 300 people standing behind it, some of whom you've seen here. And every single one of us has benefited from participating in these events as well as just the regular meets. So Varun Garg is an engineer from Ludhiana. When he came to Bombay 2 years ago, he joined us, and today he is a professional writer. He writes for radio and television. Fairy comes from a very traditional Marwadi family, and in the past year she's managed to learn guitar, she's managed to attend a metal concert, she has also taken lessons in, well, she's written song lyrics, and she's gotten into stand-up comedy. She's one of the popular stand-up comics on the circuit. She's in fact a speaker in the next speaker is her. She's going to be talking about humor and that. Janvi is the daughter of a dentist and an engineer. And when we met her, she was doing her board exams and trying to figure out where she wanted to go in life. And she's decided to take liberal arts and pursue writing, possibly as a career. Disha joined us as a poet who loved J.K. Rowling and said, I don't really write stories. I don't know how to write short stories. Well, last year she attempted her first novel and she completed her novel in 1 month. 1 month. Yeah. So these are the community is full of stories like this. I could tell you about every single member because it's my happy job to be the community manager of this community, which means it's my job to ensure that newer members are coming in, and every person who comes in, they get heard and their ideas take shape and go forward, because the community grows with that. Because if the community grows, I grow. I have become a better writer. In the past year I have gone into performance, which is not something that I thought I would ever do. And I think I'm getting quite good at it, hopefully. I don't have a PowerPoint presentation behind me and you're still listening to me. So, and because of this, I now have an influence over 300 people who are all doing amazing things and have a certain influence based on their own. Everybody who's on social media, that's a happy word, right? Influence. This is a huge influence base that I have now because of this community that I run. So, Alphabet Sambar is incidentally not a profit, not-for-profit, not-for-revenue community. But a lot of the most successful companies in the world know the same principle and they follow the same principle. So how many people use iPhones here? How many people are using MacBook Air, MacBook Pro? We are all part of the Apple community. Apple is more than just one product that I paid a lot of money for, right? Apple stands for superior technology, great design sense. And by buying this product, we are all championing the same values. It translates in the way we live our lives, in the way we do our work. We are all taking the same message forward in our own ways. And that's a very successful, I think it's a very successful case of how a company takes brand propositions and makes that into a community. And what a community can do for the company in turn as well. There are a lot of other examples like this. WordCamp itself is a community. WordCamp is run every year completely by volunteers, by different factions of people. All of us are interested in WordPress in some way or the other. And I think everybody here has benefited in different ways. Some of you came as participants last time, and some of you are speakers this year, right? And organizers this year as well. So every single one of us has started to take a chance and do something a little extra. And with a little extra effort we are doing, we are getting a chance to be something, a part of something much bigger. So that's the value of communities. And I think coming back to bloggers, as bloggers, we already have a chance to drive conversations and through those conversations create tribes. All it needs is a little bit of focus and putting some structures in place, and a community can grow. The community that I gave you an example of, that's very close to me because it's my community. It's been done on weekends. Nobody gets paid for this. This is completely, everybody's all professionals working in other jobs. We don't do any advertising. We don't even have a website of our own. It's completely grown through word of mouth and people's own participation in this. That's the value of a community. And I think that if you're a blogger, you should really be thinking about what it is that matters to you and how you can push your tribe forward into a community. Thank you.